What is matter, actually? Matter originates when energy is compressed. In other words, matter is compressed energy. You see that a material particle is full of energy. And solid things like objects, but also the bodies of living things, are composed of millions of particles, which in turn are compressed energy. So matter has a twofold aspect, one part particle and one part radiation, meaning energy. The radiation has precedence over the particle, and thus a decisive influence on structure. All matter, for example, even one bacterium, a toxin, a nutritional foodstuff, has its own wavelengths and a frequency pattern of its own. What is the situation with material particles in the body, the cells? They transmit and receive waves with distinct frequency patterns. In other words, communication takes place. This forms the basis for the body's self-regulation. We could also compare this with a modern radio device. Information is exchanged via distinct frequencies. Back to the body. As long as cells are able to communicate with each other unhindered, meaning that the body's self-regulation is therefore intact, that body can be described as being healthy. Let's now imagine that an undesired substance manages to get into the body, for example, mercury, a pathogen, or pollen. What happens? To understand this, we're going to make a short excursion into hydrological research. Depending on age, the human body consists of 40 to 80% water. Water has the ability to form clusters and store information due to its dipolar properties. Let's take a look at a water molecule. Hydrogen has a weak positive charge, oxygen a weak negative charge. As a result of this dipolar nature, the molecules can combine with one charge. As a result of this dipolar nature, the molecules can combine with one another and form so-called clusters. If, for example, a harmful substance were to now penetrate the body, water clusters would form around that substance. These clusters have a highly differentiated structure depending on the substance. The various frequency patterns and the corresponding information emitted by that harmful substance are stored exactly within the cluster itself. Even when the actual information medium no longer exists, the cluster structure bearing the stamped information can continue to exist and have a disruptive effect on the body. What happens now when this harmful substance transmits a frequency pattern on the same wavelength as those cells? The substance's frequency patterns interfere with communication between the cells. They act as a jamming transmitter. The disruption of the exchange of information leads eventually to cell malfunctions. If that malfunction persists, it displays itself in physical symptoms and changes. So, how does the BICOM device function? Let's start off with a diagnosis. With the help of the BICOM device, it can be determined which substance is causing disruption in the body. To do this, the frequency patterns of the presumably damaging substance are relayed to the patient's body via the device. With the help of a bioenergetic testing procedure, the electroacupuncture test for instance, it is determined whether the body resonates with that substance. In terms of the therapy, the following now occurs. The patient lays their hand on a metal plate, the so-called input electrode. Frequency patterns from the body are picked up by this electrode and relayed to the BICOM device via a cable. What is being dealt with here are both interference frequency patterns and physiological or healthy frequency patterns. By means of special electronics, the interference frequency patterns are separated from the healthy frequency patterns inside the device. The interference frequencies are inverted. The physiological, in other words, healthy frequencies are reinforced. These therapy frequency patterns are relayed into a so-called modulation mat lying flat against the patient's body. This mat contains a flat coil. As a result of the therapy frequency patterns, a unique, highly effective magnetic field specific to the patient is created via this coil that penetrates into the cell's innermost regions. In bioresonance therapy, the clusters resonate with the therapy frequency patterns. The interference frequency patterns are diminished, the clusters split apart, toxins are drawn off, and the strain-inducing frequency patterns are dissipated. The cells are able to communicate unhindered again. Self-regulation, and thus the body's powers to heal itself, are put back into action once more. Today there are already thousands of BICOM therapists worldwide, and the number is increasing daily.
My name is Alexander Sinkov. I am the head of the medical center at the famous Moscow hospital Red October. The 80-90% efficiency of the bioresonance therapy has proven itself in our practice.
And within 2 hours, she felt her forearm and her toes and could move everything. And she told me on the plane on the way back to Canada that she just burst into tears. She couldn't believe what was happening. Yeah, it was a wonderful story. And it was a giveaway session.
Very well put together, you know, they're very easy to learn, and there's a tremendous amount, there's a wealth of information available, like I'd say probably 20 years of clinical experience that is available.
The BICOM machine is the workhorse of the clinic. In the main, the success that I have is with gut problems, with irritable bowel syndrome, as well as with Crohn's disease, which is a very chronic disease.
We had a really bad case of cortisone withdrawal with lots and lots of food allergies, and then started the therapy. I made a video of that patient and showed it to my general practitioner. He said, "You won't be able to do it. As bad as she looks, you'll never do it. She'll retire and she won't get healthy again either." That was a while ago. Andrea visited me in 1994. She is absolutely healthy, working, got pregnant, and has no neurodermatitis at all, can eat and drink anything she wants, participates in sports, does anything she wants. That was my worst case.
What is meanwhile a good 9 years ago, I went through a transformation from an almost bitter opponent of holistic medicine to becoming a faithful supporter. In other words, what happened with me was a kind of transformation from Saul to Paul. I used to refer to holistic doctors a bit disparagingly as gut men. And today, I must say that that is a completely arrogant characterization which does not apply in the least. You can achieve so much with holistic medicine, with acupuncture, but especially with bioresonance, it is simply fantastic.
And utilize the machine in our dental practice primarily for excising amalgam, and then also for post-treatment following extractions, or as an accompaniment to periodontal therapy. Conspicuously often, we have cases of neurodermatitis and ADS, or hyperactive children who show symptoms of both illnesses at the same time. The success there is so overwhelming that we even had follow-up inquiries from nursery school teachers. What did you do with those kids?
And due to the great demand, we are treating allergy patients 90% of the time, with a great deal of success, a success ratio of about 90% too. With experiences like these, it's a pleasure to start again each and every day, a form of therapy that I certainly wouldn't part with anymore.
85% of those patients surveyed would bear the costs for a therapy themselves if their health insurance does not pay for it. The crucial point is the effectiveness.
I believe that the future of medicine will not be able to make do without biophysical therapy methods. Bioresonance therapy, if medicine truly wants to be able to deal with the steadily increasing number of chronic illnesses. If one doesn't want to just maintain a status quo and instead really relieve patients of these illnesses, then one will not be able to make do without bioresonance therapy in the future. Bioresonance therapy is going to be an important part of medicine in the future.